here we are. We're going to just do a simple two-piece mother mould on this relatively small object. This is a pine cone. I put some latex over the top of this cone to make a mould quite a while back, and I should have made the mother mould sooner because I can see the pine cone is changing shape and it's distorting the mould a little bit. But anyway, I'm going to do it today and make this two-piece plaster bandage mother mould. So first of all, we need to put some cling film over the whole of the mould, which will act as a membrane to separate the latex from the plaster bandages, which I've cut up a few pieces here, which comes from a roll. You buy all this stuff online or in your local craft shop or whatever. This is Mod Rock plaster bandages, apparently. So we'll first of all put the cling film or membrane over the top of the mould. I've got my container here also, which I will fill up with water where we can soak the plaster bandages and then apply the plaster bandages to the surface of the membrane and mould. Okay, so now I'll fill the container with water and then I'll soak the bandages. Okay, so here it goes. Just lay your bandage in there. I tend to double the bandages up. Just fold them in half, just to give you that thickness. And we'll apply the bandages just to one side of the mould. Okay, so that's this half of the mould done. I'll just wipe away or dab away some of the excess water and we'll let that go off or set up and we'll apply the other half of the split mould. Okay, I've left this for around an hour or so and it's gone off pretty well. It's still a bit damp, but that's okay. What I'm going to do now is put some Vaseline just over the edge here and that'll stop the next layer of plaster bandages sticking to the first part of the mother mould. You want to be mindful not to get the Vaseline onto your latex, but there's a barrier here anyway with the cling film because the Vaseline may contaminate the latex and ruin the latex. So we should be okay here and we'll wash this off once the mould is done anyway. So I'm just making sure the Vaseline covers the area which I'm going to cover with the second half of the mould. Okay, so it's the same process again with the plaster bandages. Let's fold that in half. And we'll just layer that up and we'll create a lip for where the mould will overlap. The second part of the mould will overlap onto the first part of the mould. Right, so there we are, there's a second part of the mould completed. I'm just running my fingers and hands over the surface just to smoothen it up. So do the same again, I'll wait for around an hour and then we'll dismantle the mother mould and take the latex mould away from the pine cone and we'll see how that turns out. Okay, so here we are, about an hour later, and now we're gonna take the mother mould away from everything else. So that's come off quite nicely. Right, I remember FB today, I think on the boards, asked me how I prepared this cone, and I did stick it down with a bit of silicon or Dow Corning from the tube. Right, so anyway, let's take this mother mould apart, if it comes apart at all, which I hope it does. One half off. And there's a second half. So we've got the two halves off. I'll move this water. Right, so I'll put the mould there, the mother mould. And now we'll peel off the latex mould and see how it's turned out. Stinky. Nice though. Pine. It doesn't smell mouldy. Might look a little bit mouldy then. Okay, so there we are. I'll just clean up this mould. It seems to have come out okay. I guess this will start opening up soon, now it can breathe. So I might mould this up at a later date once it's opened up. We'll see how that goes. In the meantime, I'll just clean this mould up and we'll have a look. Right, so just wash this off with water. I'll show you the inside. There's a bit of a pine cone that is stuck to the mould, but maybe after a few casts that'll loosen all those little bits, so I'm not too worried about that. Some of the residue of the pine cone has got into the latex mould. We might get a few nice casts out of this, and I can make a master cast and remould it from maybe plaster of Paris or something. Right, so what we'll do now is we'll trim up the mould. And I'll place that. There's one thing I did forget, which is to mark the latex mould with the mother mould. So what we'll do is we'll reassemble the mould. I should have done this before I pulled the mould out, but there we are. And I'll just make a mark here so that we know that the mould lines up. So that'll line up there. So you can see I just made a little dash in that, in the latex mould, and plus a mark on the mother mould too. Let's make that a bit more prominent. I'll just place that back together. And there we are. This mould is ready to cast concrete casts, or whatever casts. I didn't put any feet on this mould because I thought it was a bit too small. Not for me, it's just my preference. But I've got some tins here, so that'll fit nicely on the tin there. And there we are, job done. Bob's your uncle. Like I say, I let that dry out and we're ready for casting. Okay, thank you very much and see you soon. Over and out.